In our universe, there is a special force, the force of magnetism. And this man strives to master it, to bring useful progress to humanity. The man's name is not Obi-Wan Kenobi, but Bernhard Gleich. He's a physicist and an inventor, and he already has over 80 patents, as well as constantly new ideas and powerful thoughts, which he writes down in a little book. In 2001, he sketches out an idea in it that he calls MPI, magnetic particle imaging. It is designed to revolutionize medicine. More precisely, it is a medical imaging method. At the time, Bernhard Gleich is working on magnetic resonance imaging, a technology enabling the structure and function of organs, and especially pathological changes, such as tumors, to be visualized. Inside the patient's body, strong magnetic fields stimulate hydrogen atoms to move in a particular way. Hydrogen is contained in all tissue, in our organs, muscles, and bones. The stimulated hydrogen then generates signals, which the magnetic resonance tomograph converts into images. But that usually takes a long time. Bernhard Gleich wants the new technology, MPI, to be faster and with higher resolution.
Klassisches MRT.
Classic MRI is a magnetic resonance imaging method. However, it uses the weak magnetism of water. The question was, could anything be done better? Could we use the magnetism of anything with a stronger magnetic force? For example, magnetic nanoparticles. And MPI is an answer to how imaging can be done with these nanoparticles. The tiny metal nanoparticles are not the problem. They already exist. Tiny beads of iron oxide, only a few millionths of a millimeter in size, within a liquid. For Bernhard Gleich, this is definitely appealing. Injected into the body, they can be influenced by the power of a magnet, and thus generate strong magnetic signals themselves. But there's a problem, because a magnet always influences numerous particles simultaneously, all those that lie within its magnetic field. So all the particles would always be simultaneously visible for a machine. For a more precise look into the body, in high resolution and in three dimensions, the machine would have to detect particles in a very small area, like the individual pixels of a digital image. With just one large magnetic field, this cannot be done. To circumvent the problem, we have a trick in MPI, the so-called field-free point. And this is where Jürgen Weizsäcker, the co-inventor of the idea, came in. He had to find a way of using the force of magnetism to influence only a few particles at a predefined location. And he actually found a solution. The secret is a second magnetic field, and I brought one along with me here. We call this the selection field. It consists of two magnets with their north poles facing each other. And that's why, at the precise center of this arrangement, we have a magnetism-free point. We call it the field-free point. Due to the external magnetic field, all needles are magnetically frozen, as it were. Only those at the center, at the field-free point, remain unaffected by the magnetic field. If I now reapply my oscillating magnetic field, you can see that needles are moving, but that only the one in the middle is rotating along with it. That means that we're getting a pure signal now only from this single needle in the middle. So we now know there is magnetic material here at this location. And with signals like those, images could be generated 1,000 times faster than with magnetic resonance imaging. After injection of the nanoparticles, the field-free point scans a specific region and the particles are located. In this way, doctors can trace precisely whether blood in the heart is circulating smoothly. In addition, physicians would be able to detect any constriction in the blood vessels. The nanoparticles are harmless. They are degraded by the human body within days. The magnetic force is therefore a powerful tool in the diagnosis of cardiovascular disease, or even cancer. Since the path taken by the field-free point in the body is known very accurately, we can calculate the particle concentration with high precision, and we can transform that particle concentration into an image, and then produce 3D real-time videos. An MPI scanner for the human body does not yet exist, but a research version does, enabling the technology and its possibilities to be further developed. Jürgen Weizsäcker and Bernhard Gleich use it to demonstrate a further possible application. Here, the ramified glass tubes represent veins. Liquid and a metallic probe are introduced. The researchers then navigate the metal probe through the model solely via the power of magnetism. This is how doctors could one day navigate a catheter through a patient's body using a joystick. So with MPI, you can't only take pictures and detect magnetic material, you can also heat up magnetic material, manipulate magnetic objects and do all kinds of other things. It represents a fundamental basis for the most diverse applications. The two inventors demonstrate this impressively with the so-called screw ballet. They rotate as if by magic, driven only by the force of magnetism. The technology can even get things to levitate and then steers them through the air. Bernhard Gleich and Jürgen Weizsäcker are now very close to obtaining the power of Obi-Wan and his Jedi disciples. May the Force continue to be with them.